بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه أما بعد. This is our 17th lesson going through the poem الرجوزة المئية في ذكر حال أشرف البرية صلى الله عليه وسلم authored by ابن أبي العز الحنفي رحمه الله تعالى. قال المصنف رحمه الله
في مؤتات سارت وفي الصيام قد كان فتح البلد الحرام وبعده قد أورادوا ما كان في يوم حنين ثم يوم الطائف وبعد في ذي القعدات اعتماره من الجيع الرانات واستقراره وبنته زينب ماتت ثم موليد إبراهيم فيها حتما ووهبت نوبتها لعائشة سوداة ما دامت زمانا عائشة.
طيب the author رحمه الله تعالى he said لمؤتة سارت وفي الصيام قد كان فتح البلد الحرام. And so during the 8th year of the Hijra, the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he began the first, يعني you could say, war between him and the Romans. And the cause of this war was the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he sent a letter to the ruler of Busra. And he sent this letter with a companion, Harith ibn Umayr al-Azdi radiyallahu anhu. However, on the way to sending this letter, he was intercepted by one of the allies of the Romans. And he was then killed. And so the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mobilized 3,000 men to go out and gain revenge against this ally of the Romans. And so this ally of the Romans, he sought the help of the Romans, and the Romans sent him 200,000 men. And so we have 3,000 Muslims led by Zayd ibn Haritha radiyallahu anhu. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that if Zayd ibn Haritha was to be killed, then Ja'far is to take the raya, the banner. And if Ja'far is to be killed, then Abdullah ibn Rawah has to take the raya, the banner. And so now they met at this small village outside of Greater Sham called Mu'tah. طيب. And the war began, and the first leader, Zayd ibn Haritha radiyallahu anhu, gained martyrdom. Zayd ibn Haritha radiyallahu anhu arda, who we mentioned in previous lessons. He was the former adopted son of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is the first mawla, the first manumitted servant to accept al-Islam radiyallahu anhu arda. After he was killed, the banner was given to Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu, who we also mentioned in previous lessons. And Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu, he took the banner with his right hand and it was cut off during the battle. He then took it with his left hand and it was cut off. He then took it with the stubs that remained from his both hands and he brought it towards his chest and he held it with his chest. And then he was sliced in half. Alayhi radwanullah. And he gained martyrdom. And he was of course the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, وَكَانَ أَشْبَهَ النَّاسِ بِهِ. And he was the one who physically looked the most like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam named him Ja'far al-Tayyar. Ja'far al-Tayyar. The Ja'far with wings, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced his hands with wings that he will use to fly with in paradise. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wept at his death. Then the raya, the banner was given to Abdullah ibn Rawahata radiyallahu anhu wa Allah. And he was from the poets of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَكَانَ شَاعِرًا جَلِيلًا, a great poet, عَلَيْهِ رِضْوَانُ اللَّهِ. And he also fought valiantly until he was killed. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying this in real time to his companions. Jibreel came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he was informing him of the events that was going on in the battle. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was informing his companions at that same time. He says, كَمَا رَوَاهُ الْبُخَارِيُّ فِي صَحِيحِهِ مِنْ حَدِيثِ أَنَسْ رضي الله عنه وأرضاه خطب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال أخذ الراية زيد فأصيب ثم أخذها جعفر فأصيب ثم أخذها عبد الله بن رواحة فأصيب وإن عيناه وَإِنَّ عَيْنَيْهِ لَتَذْرِفَانِ. Then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ثُمَّ أَخَذَهَا خَالِدُ بْنُ الْوَلِيدِ. Then the raya was taken by none other than سيف الله المسلول خالد بن الوليد رضي الله عن رسول الله خالد بن الوليد رضي الله عنه وأرضاه فتح الله عليه and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened victory for him. And the way that Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu anhu he proclaimed victory, or the way that he gained victory, was that he switched the right flank with the left flank, fooling the Romans into thinking that reinforcements had come. Likewise, he began to drag the Romans into the desert, because the messenger, or the army of Khalid ibn Walid was a very light army, whereas the army of the Romans was a very heavy army. And so he was able to drag them into the desert. And so the Romans had they were both, number one, in fear of the reinforcements that they were duped into thinking that Khalid ibn Walid had received. Likewise, they were not able to fight in the desert. If they were to be pulled further into the desert, they wouldn't be able to cope. And so Khalid ibn Walid was able to take his forces back and go back to Medina. And that was a victory. And this was the battle of Mu'tah. And 12 from the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ was killed during this battle. And as for the Byzantines, the Romans, they lost a lot of men. They lost a lot of men. And this was the first of many, many battles that would occur between Islam and the Roman Byzantine Empire. Then the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَفِي شَهْرِ الصِّيَامِ أَوْ وَفِي الصِّيَامِ meaning by this, the month of Ramadan. The month where fasting takes place, i.e. the month of Ramadan, in the 8th year of the Hijrah. وَفِي الصِّيَامِ قَدْ كَانَ فَتْحُ الْبَادَ الْحَرَامِ. So during this year, or during this month of the 8th year, the 9th month of the 8th year, the month of Ramadan, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conquered Mecca. Remember, we said that the Messenger of Allah was in a state of a peace treaty with the Qurayshis, right? However, the Quraysh, they broke this treaty by aiding Bani Bakr against the allies of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Bani Khuza'ah. And so because they broke this treaty, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mobilized 10,000 men and they marched towards Mecca. فَدَخَلُوهَا فَاتِحِينَ And they entered into it conquering Mecca. قَالَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فِي الْقُرْآنِ إِنَّا فَتَحْنَا لَكَ فَتْحًا مُبِينًا وَقَالَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فِي الْقُرْآنِ إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ والفتح وقال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن لقد لا يستوي منكم من أنفق من قبل الفتح وقاتل أولئك أعظم درجة من الذين أنفقوا من بعد وقاتلوا likewise الله سبحانه وتعالى سيدنا القرآن لقد الله سبحانه وتعالى سيدنا القرآن لقد صدق الله رسوله الرؤيا بالحق لا تدخلن المسجد الحرام إن شاء الله آمنين محلقين رؤوسكم ومقصرين لا تخافون فعالم ما لم تعلموا فجعل من دون ذلك فتحا قريبا فتحا قريبا and so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he ordained for his prophet to enter into Mecca فاتحا ناصرا معزا عزيزا كريما عليه الصلاة والسلام Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained for the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to enter into Mecca as a conqueror so he was able to conquer Mecca عليه الصلاة والسلام he then after conquering Mecca and Mecca relented and they didn't some of them fought back but the Messenger of Allah sent small skirmishes here and there which were dealt with quickly the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gathered together the people of Quraysh and then he said to them what shall I do with you and so they said to him أخٌ كريم وابن أخٍ كريم indeed you are a honorable brother the son of an honorable brother And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء أو لا تثريب عليكم اذهبوا فأنتم الطلقاء Go, for indeed you are free, i.e. I have forgiven you. And then Quraysh entered into Islam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned Surah An-Nasr, وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا Indeed, the ummah, the Muslims or the people are not entering into the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in groups. And so when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said, Ya ma'ashara Quraysh, ma tarawna anni fa'ilun bikum. So they said, Akhun Kareem ibn Akhin Kareem. Then he said, Fa inni aqulu lakum kama qala Yusuf li ikhwatih, La tathriba alaykum al-yawm, idhabu fa antum al-tulaqha. Tayyib. Then the author رحمه الله تعالى he said وبعده قد أوردوا ما كان في يوم حنين ثم يوم الطائف Then the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَبَعْدَهُ أي after the conquest of Mecca, after the conquest of Mecca, قَدْ أَوْرَدُوا أي the ulama of Siyar, the ones who have an understanding of Sirah and they have this knowledge, they spoke about the issue of the day of Hunayn, the day of Hunayn. And this was after the conquest of Mecca. And this was after the conquest of Mecca. And so the reason why Yawm Hunayn occurred, or the reason why the battle of Hunayn occurred, is because some of the tribes that were surrounding Mecca, they did not accept the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, Bani Hawazin and Bani Thaqif. And this is why he mentioned Yawm Hunayn and Yawm Al-Ta'if. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he heard that these groups were coming out to attack the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to attack Mecca. And so they met at a land called in a land called Hawazin, near a place called Hunayn. And Malik ibn Auf, who was the leader of this mobilized army that was coming to attack the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Mecca, they left their women and children in a place called Awtas, which is why the Ghazwa of Hunayn has many different names. Some call it Ghazwa to Awtas, others call it Ghazwa to Hawazan, and others call it Ma'raka to Hunayn. طيب. And so they met the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to fight him. They met the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to fight him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in Surah At-Tawbah. قال الله تبارك وتعالى لقد نصركم الله في مواطن كثيرة ويوم حنين إذ أعجبتكم كثرتكم فلم تغن عنكم شيئا وضاقت عليكم الأرض بما رحبت ثم وليتم مدبرين ثم أنزل الله سكينته على رسوله وعلى المؤمنين وأنزل جنودا لم تروها وعذب الذين كفروا وذلك جزاء الكافرين. And so on the day of Hunayn, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions went through a lot of difficulties, and they were initially defeated. They were initially stunned by the attackers, i.e. the tribes of Hawazin, led by Malik ibn Auf. And so whenever they saw the Muslims, they would start hurling arrows and stones at them. And it was at this point where many of the army, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who had a lot of newly converted new individuals who had converted to an Islam just recently after the conquest of Mecca, and so they began to run away, or they began to retreat. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said on that day, and he had this bravery on that day, and he said, أنا النبي لا كذب أنا ابن عبد المطلب. Indeed, I am the prophet and I do not lie. I am the son of عبد المطلب. أنا النبي لا كذب وأنا ابن عبد المطلب. And so during this battle, the Messenger of Allah held firm and his companions held firm, and they were able to then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, ثم أنزل الله سكينته على رسوله وعلى المؤمنين وأنزل جنودا لم تروها وعذب الذين كفروا وذلك جزاء الكافرين. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was then able to defeat these tribes, or these people from the tribe of Hawazan. Then the author rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, ثم يوم الطائف. Then the invasion of Ta'if. And the invasion of Ta'if is actually an extension of the battle of Hunayn, because as I said, the tribe of Hawazin, they were, when they were defeated, they ran to Thaqif and they allied with Thaqif, who were in Ta'if. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent 1,000 men led by Khalid ibn Walid radiyallahu anhu arzah towards Al-Ta'if. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam besieged Al-Ta'if for around 10 to 20 days, and then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was able to capture the city of Al-Ta'if. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a famous dua, Allahumma hadi thaqifan wa'ati bihim. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, guide thaqif and bring them to Al-Islam. And likewise the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, آيبون قولوا آيبون تائبون عابدون لربنا حامدون. We mentioned this dhikr in our sharh of حصن المسلم. طيب. Then the author رحمه الله تعالى, he mentioned in the line of poetry that he said, وَبَعَدُوا فِي ذِي الْقَعْدَةِ اعْتِمَارُهُ مِنَ الْجِعِضْرَانَةَ وَاسْتِقْرَارُهُ. What is meant by جِعِضْرَانَة? جِعِضْرَانَة, ya ikhwan, refers to the place where the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم spent time in, or the place where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent time in between Mecca and Ta'if after the invasion of Al-Ta'if. So he spent this month of or just before the القعدة, or just يعني during شوال and before the القعدة, or beginning of the القعدة, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he spent a period of 10 or so days in Al-Ji'irnana. And the reason why he spent these 10 or so days in Al-Ji'irnana is to wait for the Hawazin, because now the Messenger of Allah had their war prison, had their booty, right? But you cannot distribute this booty until you wait for the Hawazin delegation to come and accept Islam. Because if they come and accept Islam, then this war prisoners, these war prisoners become free and they become part of their, they're given back to them. طيب, and the booty is given back to them, right? However, they never came. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam began to distribute the booty among the Muhajirin, especially, or among the new Muslims, not the Muhajirin, but the new Muslims, especially the likes of Abu Sufyan and Safwan ibn Umayyah and Ikrimah ibn Abi Jahl and those kind of individuals. They were given a lot of booty. And so the Ansar became a bit uneasy, because now the Messenger of Allah is given to the Sada of Quraysh, he's given to the masters of Quraysh, his people. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned his famous statement, Ya Ma'ashar al-Ansar, O people of the Ansar, what, how are you not? So he said to them, Ya Ma'ashar al-Ansar, are you not satisfied, O Ansar, that the people go back with camels and they go back with horses, whereas you go back with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, By Allah, if there had been no migration, then I would have been from the Ansar. If the people were to go through a valley and the Ansar were to go through another valley, I would take the valley of the Ansar. And if the people, Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, have mercy upon the Ansar and the children of the Ansar and the children's children of the Ansar. And the dua that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made for the Ansar, and indeed he died among the Ansar radiallahu anhu, and he was buried in the land of the Ansar radiallahu anhu ajma'in, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. And so the Messenger of Allah spent this 10-day period in Al-Ji'irana, giving out and distributing the booty. And then he made the ihram from Al-Ji'irana, and he proceeded to Mecca to perform the Umrah. And then he left ala Mecca, he left to go back to Medina, and he left as the governor of Mecca the companion Attab ibn Asid radiyallahu anhu wa ardah. Then يوثر رحمه الله تعالى he said وبنته زينب ماتت ثم مولد إبراهيم فيها حتما. Then يوثر رحمه الله تعالى mentions the death of زينب بنت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And so after the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم returned back to Medina, his daughter Zainab رضي الله عنها passed away. But after a few months post her death, a child was born for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and that was Ibrahim عليه رحمة الله ورضي عنه. So then Ibrahim رضي الله عنه was then born, and he was of course the son of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and his mother was Maria القبطية رضي الله عنها وأرضاها. Then the author رحمه الله تعالى he said ووهبت نوبتها لعائشة سودت ما دامت زمانا عائشة. Then he mentions the incident that سودة رضي الله عنها feared that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would divorce her, because she now had gone, she had become old in age. Oh, she now had reached an age where she had become old. And so what she did was, عليها رضي الله, she gave her knight to Aisha. And so Aisha became the only wife of the Prophet ﷺ with two knights. Her own knight and the knight of Sawda رضي الله عنها وأرضاها. And so the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he accepted the act of Sawda رضي الله عنها. And Sawda رضي الله عنها, she said, لا تطلقيني أمسكني وجعل يومي لعائشة ففعل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذلك فنزلت قول الله تبارك وتعالى فلا جناح عليهما أن يصلحا بينهما صلحا والصلح خير. هذا والله أعلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.